அஸ்ஸலாமு அலைக்கும் ரஹ்மத்துல்லாஹி வபரகாத்துஹு. அல்ஹம்துலில்லாஹ், பிஸ்மில்லாஹி வஸ்ஸலாத்து வஸ்ஸலாமு அலா ரசூலில்லாஹி ஸல்லல்லாஹு அலைஹி வஸல்லம். அம்மா பஅது, அஊது பில்லாஹி மினஷ் ஷைத்தானிர் ரஜீம், பிஸ்மில்லாஹிர் ரஹ்மானிர் ரஹீம். டியர் பிரதர்ஸ் அண்ட் சிஸ்டர்ஸ் இன் இஸ்லாம், த ஸ்டூடண்ட் இமாம் மஹத்தம் ஆசம் ரஹ்மத்துல்லாஹி அலைஹி ஆன்சர்ட் ஹிஸ் teacher imam shaqiq al balk rahmatullahi alayh regarding the second element he learned from the quran. Oh my teacher, I see in the world the people, they are competing, they are vying to fulfill the desires of their self, the nafs. But I see in the glorious quran, allah jalla jalalu says, fa amma man khafa maqam rabbihi wa nahan nafs anil hawa fa innal jannata hiya al ma'wa. 79 Surah Naziat verses 40 and 41, where Allah Jalla Jalla says, whereas for the one who, for the fear of standing in the maqam of his Lord, in the place of his Lord, and refrains from the evil desires of the self, his verily, his abode, he will be the paradise, Jannatul Ma'wa. What a beautiful promise given by Allah Jalla Jalla. Unfortunately, we are always succumbing to the induction, to the persistence of our nafs, and we are vying to fulfill the desires of the nafs. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam has also warned us. Once he addressed his sahabas, and he said, do you know a friend, would you like to have a friend who, if you starve him, he will obey you, but if you feed him, he will make you obey and he will destroy you. And I'm giving the just a gist of this hadith. And when the sahabas asked him, who will like such a friend, our beloved Prophet warned, and this friend is the nafs. So you should not follow the nafs. And the nafs al ammara, which he will normally induces us to do with them for the illegal and haram things, we should refrain from doing for the sake of to seek the pleasure of Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, and for the fear of standing in front of the maqam of our Lord. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam would always seek dua with Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, Allahumma ati nafsi taqwaha anta waliyuha mawlaha anta khairun zakkaha. The first verses say, Allahumma ati nafsi taqwaha. The Prophet asked Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, ya Allah, please give me taqwa to nafs. Inshallah, we should also regularly ask this dua, and particularly we should insist our young generation, who are very much the target of the nafs al-ammara, to ask this dua regularly, so that they will be saved from the haram things. And the important point to be noted, be they the younger generation or ourselves, we should refrain from the evil desires of our nafs, not for the fear of defaming our family, not for the fear of defaming our forefathers, not for the fear of defaming our predecessors, but for the fear of standing in front of our Lord. That should be the sole purpose. We can see, particularly when some young generation in a particular family, the young man, he commits sins. For example, he has got alcoholism, or he is having gambling, any other sin if he is doing, and the family member, the parents know, they advise him. They advise him with the saying that you are doing, you are from such a noble family, your father was a noble people, and your predecessor, your alims, so you should not defame your family. And this is what most of the parents advise their children, but this is slightly, there is a part of hypocrisy. Actually, the children should be taught, children should be warned to refrain from the evil desires of the nafs, and we ourselves should also, we should refrain from the evil desires of the nafs, not for defaming, for the fear of defaming our family or our predecessors, but for the fear of standing in the maqam of the place of Lord, we should refrain from the sins of induced by our nafs. Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, in the glorious Quran, various places, he has warned about the nafs. And Allah also has said, Yes, nafs, he has given the straight path as well as the sin. What are the sins that you want? He says Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. Another surah about the nafs, and that is another part of the discussion. Inshallah, we will proceed in the next part. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.